Hello, my name is Mario. Welcome to another video. In today's episode, I will share with you another tip for building microservices in Go, specifically how to implement pagination using Elasticsearch. So how does pagination work in Elasticsearch? First of all, if you haven't seen the previous video where I cover Elasticsearch, how to index the records and whatnot, I will be leaving the link in the description as well, so you can check it out and watch it whenever you have some free time. So the way it works in Elasticsearch is, consider you have a bunch of records. You may have a few, you may have a few of them, or some of them, or you have a lot of them. In the context of searching for something that you want to paginate, all of that is considered a total of n records. From there, what happens is, according to what the search API included in the Elasticsearch service allows us to do, is that there is a way to define a from that indicates the beginning of a search and a size. And that size allows us to literally select everything that begins from the from parameter to the size that indicates basically the length of that array of elements. If you remember the way we implemented this API when we were searching tasks in our to-do microservices, we were returning an array of tasks. And what is going to happen now is that we're going to be returning also the number of how many records match whatever values we're searching for. So, and that the way it works is that in the context of the customer can be jumping the from and the size, and can be literally change the way they want to search whatever values they want to indicate. That's why we have a value that indicates how many records are available. So the customer that we have, our client, can say, hey, I want to start from this index, and this is the length of the records that I want to use. Let's see how it works in real life. As usual, the link to the code will be in the description. There is a concrete commit hash that you can use for actually cloning and playing with this code. So the way it works is that we're going to be using Elasticsearch, a few different options in the search API for searching concrete elements that we need to search for. We are going to be indicating the size, and we're going to be indicating the from that will be literally saying, hey, we're going to start from here, and this is how long it's going to be. Before I start to do that, let me show you the containers that I have. I'm using Docker instead of using any other local server. And the important bit that I change in this case will be, let me open message broker, but basically if you notice, I'm not running the Docker container for Elasticsearch. So what I'm going to be doing is, I'm going to be running the Docker container because I want to show you some important bit about this. So I'm going to be running Docker logs, and then follow, and I'm going to wait a little bit until it actually completes. And I wanted to complete those first time because I'm going to be defining this thing called mapping. And mapping is a way for Elasticsearch to sort of modify the data that we're indexing in a way that can be useful for searching in the future. So we are going to be defining a few mappings here. One of them will be ID, that is going to be using a keyword, will literally indicate, hey, this value is unique across the board. And this is a new field called description that indicates this is a text, something searchable and whatnot. And this is important because depending on how you map your records, you will have different options to sort and search those records. So, and Elasticsearch has a ton of different options, so I'm not going to cover all of them, and I'm definitely going to be missing some of them, but this will be the beginning of, you know, this series covering Elasticsearch. So it looks like it finished running, and what is going to happen next, I'm going to be running this curl statement that is going to be creating the mapping. Everything seems to be running, and then I'm going to be running your usual REST server using the configuration that we have. Let's move this tab right here so it makes more sense. We're going to be still using the indexer that happens to be using Redis. I made a mistake. Let's run the example. So I have my server running right there, my indexer running right there. And if I go and look at the Swagger UI, you will see that is working, you know, as expected. I don't have anything, obviously, in the database because it's a brand new database and a brand new container. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be running a different CLI, all right, the CLI that we used before when we were talking about the open telemetry and whatnot, and the Swagger and those kind of things. And again, all of this will be linked in the description, so you can clone it and you can see those videos as well. So what is going to happen is that I updated the CLI to actually create 100 records, and then those records will be indexed through the events that are going to be sent from the HTTP API to the, in this case, we'll be using PubSub Redis. And again, the link will be in the description if you want to see that video. And all the records will be created right there after receiving the events. So if I refresh the database, you will notice that I have a bunch of tasks that happen to be using a similar content that just literally, you know, doing a for loop from 1 to 100. 101, so we can start from 1 to 100 in the context of the name and the description of the task. So it's basically a bunch of these, right? So we have, you know, from 99 to 1, okay? So the way Elasticsearch allows you to search values using pagination is literally indicating a value that says, like I said, a from and a size, and we're going to be using that value to pass it down to the Elasticsearch API. And from that, what I did I modified the REST implementation that I have for supporting those endpoints. Those arguments. So if I go to the actual search task request, there are two new fields that are used for passing those down to the service that then in the end passes those down to the actual Elasticsearch store. And one thing that I introduced is the concept of an args type for both the args that are going to be received by the service and sort of the results that are going to be received or sent back from the service back to the client, which in this case will be the HTTP layer. So if I look at the service in task, you will notice that the search implementation that is right here is actually, where are you? It's right here, is just receiving the arguments that I mentioned before that are the internal search args that indicate previously these were defined as literally each one of these arguments, each one of these fields was an argument, but now we have a type that sort of consolidates all of those arguments into one. The idea is that we don't have to, we don't make our methods don't receive too many arguments. So it's sort of easier to handle in the end. But one of the cons is that obviously, depending on how big or how many arguments or fields we have in this type, maybe depending on the function or method that is using this type, maybe that function or method is not using all those fields. So there is a lint that sort of covers this, and I will leave the link in the description as well, so you can consider that case as well. But in the end, when we look at the Elasticsearch task implementation, you will notice that I also made another modification that was including a way to sort the results by score, and the score literally indicates, hey, for the values that you input in the request, how many of those match the results that happen to be available in our index records. So if I say task, which will be a description, and I say hello, and there are a few of them that happen to have task, and the priority will be high or low, then it will be sorted by first, the ones that match what we have, which will be the description plus the priority, and then everything that happens to match afterwards. And again, like I mentioned before, there is the from and the size that are applicable to Search API. And then from there, because we mapped the records previously using the instruction that I mentioned here, we can actually sort the values. And this is important to have, and there is a way to do it afterwards if you happen to already have records already indexed. There is a way to update the mappings, but I want to show you this way because it's a little bit easier. And let's see how this works in real life. So if I search task, and if I say, let me remove all of these. And if I say from 0 to 10, and you will notice that the tasks are sorted by the ID because that's what I'm indicating in the configuration that I have in the sort argument, in the sort field. So I'm telling you, hey, sort by score, which indicates everything that happened to have either, happen to have task, which in this case, all of the records that I created happen to have task. But afterwards, I want you to sort by the ID in an ascending way. So everything that comes afterwards will be using 0, 0, 0, 9, and so on and so forth. If I change the value from, you will notice that if I go, I don't know, 5 to 5, it's going to be, you know, pushing the beginning, and now it's selecting a different ID. And that's how basically pagination works. And again, this is one way to do it, and depends on how you are using or what data store you're using. So let's jump into the conclusions, and then we can talk more about this. So this is an example using Elasticsearch, but in practice, you should be able to do similar things using whatever data store you're using. Depending on how you're planning to search your records, there are different ways to do it. Using databases, it includes doing or requires doing different things. And in the case of Elasticsearch, it also is not as easy as you may think. And not because it's not using the search API is difficult, but it's more related to the to how the values are indexed and mapped. And this is sort of one of those things that Elasticsearch is one of those difficult things in Elasticsearch that require a little bit of reading. And I will be, again, leaving a few links in the description so you can read about how to map a few fields, how you should be mapping your fields depending on how you want to search those fields and the indexes that you need to use or you should be using, and obviously how to use the search API. But hopefully all of this makes sense. And again, the link will be in the description. Thank you for watching, and I will talk to you next time, okay? See you next time, and take care.